Good afternoon, everybody, and welcome. Thank you very, very much for coming. The work on show here today is of John Kingerlee, who lived in the Beara Peninsula for many years.
So things were going pretty well for John Kingerlee. In his early years as a painter, he had enormous success. The film director Stanley Donen liked his work. So of course, when he bought it, all the movie stars started buying it as well. Until about 1980, and very gradually, he became very disenchanted with the materialism of London at that time. So he and his wife, Mo, upped and moved to West Cork. They rented this little house. It couldn't be more remote. It had no Moncons, no electricity, no running water. It was a mile uphill to the house, so everything had to be carried up there. And they might still be there to this day, but for something that happened. One of the most important art critics in the world, the chief art critic for the New York Times, happened to come across some of John Kingerlee's paintings and was so impressed, he flew over to Ireland to meet him. And that started a whole chain of events. The next important art professional to come was Ted Pillsbury. And I'm going to read you a little bit from what he said in my interview. I first saw John's work some years ago in a private collection and thought it to be of exceptional quality. One of the things I noticed was the small scale of the paintings, some of them painted on boards the size of a book. Now, of course, traditionally, artists who paint on a small scale are perceived to have a small vision, and I was curious to find out if he was an artist of small ideas or if he'd something more important to say. Having observed him at work, in my view, he is one of the most important, certainly one of the most talented artists working today. There's an analogy with someone like Paul Klee, who worked on a small scale, but who dealt with some of the greatest issues of his time. John Kingerlee's art, more than a unique vision of nature, is a lone voice of responsibility in a world beset by consumption and exploitation.
I sort of feel I came to John Kingerlee almost accidentally compared to other people in this room, but I first heard about him when I was curating a show for the Crawford Gallery. And John Kingerlee was suggested to me, and when I saw his work, I was amazed because it was both far too sophisticated for that show and absolutely right. And over the years, John Kingerlee has adopted a cartoon-like signature to his work. It's a man in a boat rowing with one oar, and it symbolizes for him the artist following his own path. Stubbornly, perhaps, if you look at it, but steadfastly, being true to his own impulses, not being influenced by fashion or mammon or any of these things. He says, and I think this echoes something Roz said, he said, "Just to be here is a miracle. I'd like to communicate that to people." You see, nearly everything you say about John Kingerlee, you can immediately contradict. Maybe that's why he doesn't say much. He also has a series of grid paintings, which are very important to him. Some of them are almost pure white, and they're very soothing. And recently, he's taken to producing works that he calls Strix. And in contrast to the coolness of the grid paintings, these are busy paintings, and they're quite different, and they really do reward a long, hard look. And it's amazing to think they're the most recent work of a man of 80. Get up close while they're here, and have a really good look. Let them speak to you. Thank you.